Today I'll show you how to find the right wrench or socket to fit a bolt or nut if you don't know if it's metric or standard. Also, how to identify markings on bolt heads, which sizes are interchangeable, plus a little mechanic math. There's a link in the description to download a handy chart you can print on cardstock and keep in your toolbox. This chart converts both standard and metric to thousandths of an inch so they can be directly compared. You may run into a mix of metric and standard bolts on the same vehicle, especially on U.S. cars and trucks from the 1970s and 80s. Both foreign and newer U.S. vehicles after 2000 are mostly metric, but you might still find standard bolts on older components or parts like spark plugs, battery cables, lug nuts, or bleeder screws, also tools and yard equipment. You can see on this chart that 5/16 of an inch and 8 millimeter wrenches and sockets are so close they are interchangeable. 5 divided by 16 rounded up is 0.313 inches. 1 millimeter is 0.0394 inches. Multiply that by 8 millimeters equals 0.315 inches. So we can see that 8 millimeters is only 2/1000ths of an inch bigger than 5/16, which is extremely close. This size is pretty common on hose clamps, and the two wrenches or sockets fit basically the same. If a wrench size is too small, like this 3/8 inch, look at the chart for the next largest size, which is a 10 millimeter, a very common size with no equivalent in SAE. 7/16 is way too big. 7/16 and 11 millimeter are only 4/1000ths of an inch different, so they are interchangeable, and either one fits this bolt on my rotor tiller just fine. 1/2 inch is often considered to be equal to 13 millimeters, and either will work well in most cases, but 1/2 inch is actually 12/1000ths of an inch smaller. So if you have both available and the 1/2 inch works, I would use it because you'll get a tighter fit, thus less chance of stripping. Bolt head markings can get complex and often have a manufacturer's initials on them. If you see radial lines, it's SAE, also known as standard or Imperial. If it has a number like 6 or 8.8, it's metric. This SAE construction bolt fits a 1/2 inch wrench. It's a little loose in the 13 millimeter. We know this bolt is metric because it says 8.8 on the head, a common metric marking. And even though it's metric, it fits nice and snug in the 1/2 inch wrench, a little looser in the 13 millimeter. You can tell by the 6 on this bolt that it's metric, and a 14 millimeter fits it well. 9/16 fits it too, a little bit looser. The standard SAE construction bolt also fits tighter in the 14 millimeter. A 9/16 inch is too small for this nut on our engine mount. The next size up is a 15 millimeter, a very common size. The 5/8 is way too loose. You'd strip the nut before you got it off, so there's no substitute for a 15 millimeter. And 5/8 is almost identical to a 16 millimeter. A 17 millimeter will not go on this nut, but an 11/16 inch fits it just fine, so we can see that they are not interchangeable. And lastly, 3/4 inch is almost identical to 19 millimeters, and there are many more that are interchangeable as the sizes get larger. I found it very handy to have this chart, which is in the description below the video. Please check out our YouTube channel for more informative videos, and feel free to like, subscribe, and comment. Thank you.